Hello everyone. Today I will talk about some important functions of Laplace transformations such as impulse function, unit impulse function, that means drag delta function, and I will give some important formulae of the Laplace transformation. So first of all, let us start with impulse function. Okay, impulse can be regarded as the impulse can be considered a large force acting for a very small time. So if we formulate it mathematical model, then we can write impulse function of Ft as F epsilon, we can denote it as F epsilon t minus A, and we can write it as 1 by epsilon when your time is between A and A plus epsilon, and it is 0 for the remaining cases. So your impulse function can be regarded as 1 upon epsilon, that is very small, that is 1 by epsilon, and if epsilon tends to 0, your impulse will be 1 by epsilon, and this is for when your t lies between A and A plus epsilon, that means for a small time period. So here is the impulse is 1 by epsilon. So you can draw its graph. So your F epsilon t minus A is here. This is your 1 by epsilon for the small period. That means if this is your A and that is your A plus epsilon, then for this small period, our value of F epsilon t minus A is 1 by epsilon. Okay, if A is 0, then F epsilon t can be written as 1 upon epsilon when your t lies between 0 to epsilon, and it is 0 in the remaining cases. So we can say that this is the shifted property, and this is when your A is 0. So this is your impulse function of the function ft. Okay. Now the Laplace. Now this function can also be written as, this was your 1 by epsilon when your t was between A to A plus epsilon, and this was 0 in the remaining cases. Now this can be also written as, you can also represent it in terms of unit step function. You know that ut minus A, we know that ut minus A is 1 when your t is greater than A. So the value of ut minus A will be 1 because your t is greater than A. And we also know that the value of ut minus A is 0 when your t is less than A. That means when your t is less than A plus epsilon, the value of ut minus A plus epsilon will be 0. So this is true when your t is between A plus epsilon and it is 0 in the remaining cases. This is your 1 because t is greater than A, and it is 0 because t is less than A plus epsilon. Now its Laplace will be 1 upon epsilon. The Laplace of ut minus A and the Laplace of ut minus A plus epsilon. We know the Laplace of this one, which is your e to the power minus as upon s, and the Laplace of this one will be e to the power minus a, in place of a we have a plus epsilon s upon s. So you can take e to the power minus as common, so in the bracket we will have 1 minus e to the power minus s epsilon divided by s epsilon. So this is the Laplace of epsilon s epsilon t minus a, that means of impulse function. Now let us talk about Dirac delta function. Dirac delta function is very important for various engineering branches because it has many applications. So direct delta function is defined as, we denote it by delta t minus a, and this is your epsilon, limit epsilon tends to 0 f of epsilon t minus a. That means when your epsilon is 0, when your epsilon tends to 0, then the limit of this function when your epsilon tends to 0 is known as Dirac delta function. So its Laplace will be, the limit of epsilon tends to 0 and the Laplace of f epsilon t minus a. So now we have the formula for this function, which is your e to the power minus a s 1 minus e to the power minus s epsilon divided by s epsilon. So if we put epsilon tends to 0, then you can see that here we will have 1 minus 1 because e to the power 0 is 1, so it will be 1 minus 1, that means 0. And again here we have epsilon, so this will be of the type 0.0. So you can use L-hospital, that means we can differentiate the numerator with respect to epsilon and again the denominator with respect to epsilon. So this will be epsilon tends to 0, e to the power minus a s, the differentiation of 1 will be 0, and this will be your epsilon, e to the power minus s epsilon, and the derivative of epsilon will be 1. So this is your s. Now, so here is the mistake, and the differentiation of this with respect to epsilon will be s. Okay. Now, if we put epsilon tends to 0, this will be your 1, so s will be cancelled with s, so this is your simply e to the power minus as. Thus, we can say that the Laplace of delta t minus a is e to the power minus as. Now, if we put a equal to 0, then you can say that the Laplace of delta t is equal to 1. And from here, we can say that the Laplace inverse of 1 is delta t. So the Laplace inverse of 1 is delta t. Again, we have a very important property of Dirac delta function, which is the value of this integral ft delta t minus a is your f of a. The value of this integral is your f of a. Okay, that is all about your Dirac delta function. Now we will talk about some very important formulae of Laplace transformation, such as the derivative of the Laplace transformation, integral of the Laplace transformation. First, I am going to tell the derivative, the Laplace of the derivative of a function. So say theorem number 1, if Laplace of ft is equal to fs, that means again, if the Laplace of the function exists, then the, it means the function has to be sectionally continuous and of exponential order. So if the Laplace of ft is fs, then the Laplace of f dash t will be s into fs minus f of 0. This formula is very important for solving the differential equation or even ordinary, even partial differential equation, because there will be some derivative of the function y, and the Laplace of f dash t is equal to s square fs minus s f0 minus f dash 0. And we can generalize it, and in general the Laplace of nth derivative of t is equal to s to power n fs minus s to power n minus 1 f0 minus s to power n minus 2 f dash 0, and then dot 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 minus. You can say that, you can see that here we have f0, then we have the first derivative, and then we will have here dot 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 minus f. So you can see that if we have double derivative, at this place, then here we have first derivative, and so here we will have f and minus 1 0. So the Laplace of f and t is equal to s and fs minus s and minus 1 f 0. Now you can see that the degree of the derivative is going to increase. Here we have first derivative, then we will have second derivative, and at the last we will have n minus 1 derivative. Now we will prove this theorem. So the Laplace of f dash t is equal to, you can use the definition, 0 to infinity e to power minus st ft f dash t dt. We can integrate this f dash t and it will be e to power minus st. The integration of f dash t will be ft, and that the limits are from 0 to infinity, and then we will differentiate this e to power minus st with respect to t. So the differentiation of e to power minus st will be minus s, and here we have a minus, then it will be your plus s, 0 to infinity. Now this is your e to power minus st, and the integration of f dash t is ft. So on putting the upper limit, we will get e to power minus infinity, which is 0, and the lower limit will be f0. And this is your Laplace of ft. So we have s Laplace ft minus f0, and we can also write it as s fs minus f0. So you can see that the Laplace of f dash t is equal to Laplace ft minus f0. That means the derivative sign has been removed. There is no derivative sign. So the Laplace of f double dash t is equal to the Laplace of f dash t whole dash. So using the same technique and say this equation, you can see that Laplace of f dash t was s times Laplace of ft minus f0. Using the same technique, you can see that this derivative sign will get removed, and we have s Laplace f dash t minus f dash 0. This outside derivative sign has been removed, and now in place of f we have f dash at this step. So again, use the formula of Laplace f dash t, we will get s into fs minus f0 minus f dash 0. So this is equal to s square fs minus sf0 minus f dash 0. Now continuing this same technique, we can have the formula for Laplace of nth derivative of t, and that will be your s power n fs minus s power n minus 1 f0 and so on. So I am not going to that, so I will start with the next theorem, which is if Laplace of ft equal to fs, whenever I get Laplace of ft equal to fs, that means I assume that the Laplace of ft exists, and that means the function is sectionally continuous and of exponential order. So if this is equal to fs, then the Laplace of t to the power n ft is equal to minus 1 power n d to the power n dsn of fs. That means the Laplace of t to the power n ft is equal to minus 1 power n into the nth derivative of fs. That means the Laplace of ft with respect to s. So proof. We will prove the result by using the mathematical induction on this n. So we will apply mathematical induction on this n. So let us assume n equal to 1. So if n is equal to 1, then we have to prove that Laplace t into ft equal to minus d by ds of fs. So this condition should be satisfied. So to prove this condition, I will start with the right hand side. So let us start with the right hand side, and this is equal to minus d by ds of fs. Fs means the Laplace of ft. So we have the formula for Laplace of f t, which is equal to 0 to infinity e to the minus st f t dt. Okay, now we have to differentiate this integral. We cannot directly differentiate this integral. We have a rule of Leibniz, and which says that if the limits are constant, this is true for only when the limits are constant. Now if the limits of the integration are constant, then this derivative sign becomes the partial derivative. That means due to the Leibniz rule of differentiation under integration sign, we will have, this is equal to, we will have integral 0 to infinity, the partial derivative will now become, the total derivative will now become the partial derivative of e to the power minus st ft. So now we have to partially differentiate this term with respect to s. Now as we have to differentiate with respect to s, so this ft will be constant. This was because of Leibniz rule of differentiation under integration sign. Okay, now on differentiating e to the power minus st with respect to s, we will get minus t outside, and this minus minus plus become this minus, and this minus will become plus, so we will have e to the power minus st t f t dt, and this is your 0 to infinity e to the power minus st f t dt. That means the Laplace of t f t, and that is your the left hand side. So the Laplace of t f t equal to minus t by ds of f s. That means we can say that the result is true for n equal to 1. Thus the result is true for n equal to 1. Now let us assume that the result is true for n equal to some positive integer k. Let the result is true for n equal to k, that is Laplace t power k f t is equal to minus n to power k d power k ds of k of f s. So now we will prove the result for n equal to k plus 1. That means we need k plus 1 in place of k. For that, let us differentiate this equation with respect to s. Now from that we will have this k as k plus 1. So let us differentiate. So this is equation number 1. Differentiating 1 with respect to s. So let us start with the right hand side. So we will have minus 1 to power k dk plus 1 of ds k plus 1 of fs equal to, now start with the left hand side, d by ds of Laplace t to power k ft. Now open the definition of Laplace. This is equal to 0 to infinity e to power minus st t to power k ft dt. Again, due to the Leibniz rule of differentiation under integration sign, this total derivative will become partial derivative, and rest is constant. So the differentiation of e to the power minus st with respect to s will be e to the power minus st, and the differentiation of minus st with respect to s will be minus t. And 1 t to the power k is there, so this will be your t to the power k plus 1 ft dt. You can take minus sign common, so this is your, okay, so this is equal to 0 to infinity e to the power minus st t to the power k plus 1 ft dt, and you can also write it as, you can also write the right hand side as minus, this is the Laplace of t to the power k plus 1 of ft. Now sitting this minus sign on the left hand side, this left hand side will get minus 1 to power k plus 1, d of k plus 1, ds of k plus 1 of fs is equal to the Laplace of t to the power k plus 1 of ft. So you can see that now in place of k, earlier we were having k at this place. Now in place of k, we have k plus 1. So we can say that the result is true for all the positive integer values of n. Hence, by mathematical induction, the result is true for all positive integer values of n. Okay, thus we can say that Laplace of t to the power n ft is equal to minus 1 to the power n into the nth derivative of fs. So next we have the theorem, if Laplace of ft equal to fs, then Laplace of ft upon t is equal to integral s to infinity fs ds. If the Laplace of ft is equal to fs, then the Laplace of the fraction ft upon t is equal to the integral s to infinity fs ds. We can also change this variable s to u or any other variable. So proof. Let us write ft upon t as gt. Then ft will be t times gt. Okay, now take the Laplace, taking Laplace transform, we will have Laplace of ft is equal to Laplace t times gt, and the Laplace of t into gt will be, now use the previous theorem, the Laplace of t of ft was minus d by ds of fs. Fs means the Laplace of ft. So using the previous theorem, this will be equal to minus d by ds of Laplace gt, and the Laplace of ft is equal to fs. Now just see your proof. We have to prove this integral is equal to this one. So now let us integrate this equation with respect to s from s to infinity. Now integrate this equation with respect to s from s to infinity. So we get s to infinity fs ds. So now on integration, this derivative sign will get removed. So we will have Laplace gt, and then the limits are from s to infinity. Okay. Now what will be the value of upper limit? This can also be written as, remember that the limits are with respect to s, because we have done integration with respect to s. So this is your s to infinity Laplace gt minus the Laplace of gt. Because for the lower limit, we are just replacing s by s. So, you know that the Laplace of gt is equal to integral 0 to infinity e to power minus st gt dt. So, when you replace s by s, you will just get Laplace gt. So, this is your Laplace gt. And when you will put s tends to infinity, then this will become your e to power minus infinity, which is 0. So, your upper limit will be 0. And here we have just Laplace of gt, and gt what? Ft upon t. Thus we have proved that Laplace of ft upon t is equal to integral s to infinity fs ds. Therefore Laplace ft upon t is equal to integral s to infinity fs ds. Now this formula have some important deduction. Just try to expand this left hand side. On expanding the definition of Laplace, on using the definition of Laplace, we will have Laplace of ft upon t will be e to the power minus st ft upon t dt equal to integral s to infinity fs ds. The definition of Laplace ft upon t is this thing. Now just put s equal to 0. Let us put s equal to 0. So on putting s equal to 0, we will have 0 to infinity ft upon t dt equal to 0 to infinity fs ds. This is very important deduction of this particular formula. Here we can see that we have the value of this improper integral as 0 to infinity fs ds, where remember where fs is the Laplace of ft, our notation. Again we can generalize this formula as Laplace of ft upon t for n is equal to n time integration from s to infinity of fs with respect to s. If we have t to power n, then we will have n time integration of fs with respect to s. Then next theorem, if Laplace of ft is equal to fs, then the Laplace of integral 0 to t fu du is equal to fs upon s. So let us assume this bracket is equal to gt. So let us assume this integral 0 to t fu du is equal to gt. Then the derivative of this integral is equal to, if you find out the derivative of this function, then it will be equal to f of t, as t is the upper limit, and g 0, that means when your t is 0, this will be your 0. Okay, now taking the Laplace of this equation, we get Laplace g dash t equal to Laplace of ft, and Laplace of g dash t is equal to, use the formula of the derivative, that was the Laplace of gt minus g0, and the Laplace of f dash ft is equal to fs. So as g0 was 0, so this is your Laplace gt equal to fs. So the Laplace of gt means the Laplace of the integral 0 to t fu du is equal to fs upon s. So this is all about this particular theorem. Then these are the four important theorems of Laplace transformation. Now I will discuss about the periodic function and its Laplace transform. Periodic function. A function ft is said to be periodic of period say small a if your ft plus n a equal to ft. If ft plus n a is equal to ft, then we say that this is of periodic function. This is periodic function or period is small a. Now what do you mean by this ft n plus a? So if n is equal to 1, then we will have ft plus a equal to ft. Then again we will say that this is a periodic of period a. Now what is the purpose of writing this n? You know that sine theta plus 2 pi is sine theta, and again sine theta plus 4 pi is again sine theta. So
If A is the period of this AP, then this A has to be least for which this condition is satisfied. So if A is the periodic, if A is the period of this function, then we will say that ft plus A equal to ft. And the Laplace of this ft is equal to 1 upon 1 minus e to power minus as, then the integral 0 to a e to power minus st ft dt. Please remember that here a is your period of the function ft. So to prove this theorem, we will use the definition of Laplace ft, which is equal to 0 to infinity e to power minus st ft dt. So as we have integral 0 to a in the proof, so we will try to break this integral in various integrals using the property of definite integral. So this will be your 0 to a, then a to 2a, then 2a to 3a, and so on. Say this is your integral I, second one I1, third one I2, and so on. And let us assume this one as equation number 1. Now our aim will be to evaluate I1, I2 in terms of this I, so that this I will come outside and we will have this particular result. So proof. Now your I1 is equal to a to 2a, if t equal to u plus a. Now I am assuming this t equal to u plus a, so that our lower limit will become 0. If we put u, if we put this t equal to a, then u will be 0, and if t is equal to 2a, then u will be a. So your dt will be du, and your I1 will be, see the limits, if t equal to a, then u will be 0, and if t equal to 2a, then u will be a e to the power minus s. As we have changed our variable in terms of u, so this will be your u plus a, f u plus a, and dt is du. So again, as e to power minus as is constant, so you can take it outside. So in the bracket we will have 0 to a e to power minus su, and as the function was periodic or period small a, so this ft plus a or fu plus a will be your fu. And you know that in definite integral we can change the variable, we can replace the variable if the function is fixed, so we can write it as 0 to a e to power minus st ft dt. So thus we have I1 in terms of this I, where my I was this particular integral. Similarly, we will evaluate I2. Now I2 is equal to a to 2a e to power, my I2 was 2a to 3a e to power minus st ft dt. So again, let us assume t equal to u plus 2a. Again, the purpose was to remove the limits in terms of I, and the limits of I was from 0 to a. So we have assumed t equal to u plus 2a, so that my lower limit will become 0 and the upper limit will be 3a equal to u plus 2a, that means a. So from here we will have dt equal to u, and our I2 will be, and our I2 will be from 0 to a e to power minus s. Now this t will be your u plus 2a, and ft plus 2a, ft will be your fu plus 2a, and dt will be du. So we can write it as e to power minus 2as integral 0 to a e to power minus su. Again, the function ft is periodic, so we can write ft plus 2a as ft. Again, indefinite integral, we can change the variable. So this is equal to 0 to a integral e to power minus st ft dt. Thus, continuing in this way, we have this Laplace of ft is equal to, the first integral was I, that means 0 to a e to power minus st ft dt, and the value of the second integral was e to power minus as 0 to a e to power minus st ft dt. The value of the third integral was e to power minus 2as 0 to a e to power minus st ft dt, and so on. So you can take this bracket common, this integral common. Then in the bracket we will have 1 plus e to power minus as e to power minus 2as and so on. And now this is the GP of infinite, this is the sum of GP, geometric progression of infinite terms, where the common ratio is e to power minus as and your first term is 1. And you know that the sum of the geometric progression of infinite terms is equal to a, that means the first term, upon 1 minus the common ratio. So your answer is this one. So the Laplace of the periodic function is equal to 1 upon 1 minus e to power minus as, where a is the period, integral 0 to a e to power minus st ft dt. So that is all about this lecture. In the next lecture, I will tell you the Laplace of Bessel function and the Laplace of the error function. And we will try to solve many questions related to this Laplace transformation.